Now, I'd like to go on to my personal journey, because what I think is really important is I'm standing up here with my neighbor, with my gown and my hat, right? To tell you a little bit who I am, to try to make a connection. And hopefully, some of you can relate to the story. Some of it may be your story that I'm telling. Maybe to some of you, right? But for my development years, I grew up in, I was raised in Omaha, south and north Omaha. And if you've ever been to south and north Omaha, those are probably the worst places you can live in Omaha. It's like the best of both worlds, north and south. I grew up in a low-income project housing, and if you see the third awning, that's where me and my four sisters, my two sisters and my one brother lived in a three-bedroom house with our family. Our basic needs were met. We had clothes, we had food, we had shelter. Those were met, but there was an absence of culture. Again, remember, the statistics said that the immigrant needed culture. Well, in an urban setting, they didn't have that opportunity, right? Early education, K through 4. I attended 8 public schools and 1 BIA school. I lagged academically in speech and phonics. I teetered on the cusp of truancy. I had a natural gravitation to doing things that were probably against grain or considered bad. But there was absence of culture. And if there was a game that was designed around education, please have heard this a couple times, it was a Monopoly board for education. Those are all the schools that I went to within those first couple of years. And while it may look a little bit chaotic for some of you, because you're talking about moving at least twice a year, right? It helps you instill diversity within myself and perseverance. So that was really key takeaway from that challenging environment that I had in an urban setting. Middle education. 5th through 8th grade school, I went to the BIA school and one boarding school. That's when we moved back to North Dakota. I excelled in academic and sports, increased self-identity, esteem, and confidence. And there's a strong presence of traditional language and culture. And so what I like to tell the story behind this this picture here is there wasn't a whole lot of reasons for a bunch of Native American boys to stand up and say we're number one. These are my brothers and cousins, and it was very important to us in sports to excel, and we were champions. And that kind of set the pace, the tone for my high school education, right?